Good morning. So in the last class we have seen the amplitude modulation and the double sideband suppressed carrier. So there we have seen the wastage of power along with the wastage of bandwidth. So in order to overcome the wastage of bandwidth, we have moved on to the double sideband suppressed carrier. So there what we have done, there is in order to overcome the power minimization, we have designed the double sideband suppressed carrier. So there we have suppressed the carrier in order to send the only the message, that is M of T. So because in order to overcome the disadvantage of both the power as well as the bandwidth, we have got a solution called as a sideband, single sideband modulation. Okay, so here we are going to overcome the disadvantage of both. It is present in the amplitude modulation as well as the DSB SC. So here you can see the name itself says that single sideband modulation. So no need to include both the upper sideband as well as the lower sideband in order to transmit the message signal. Either of any one we are going to consider for the transmission of the message signal, that is either USB, that is upper sideband, or LSB, that is lower sideband, is used to transmit the message signal. So in order to represent the frequency domain description, so let us consider, we are going to represent like this. So let us consider this as the M of F. So this is what message signal. So in order to represent with respect to the DSBS, what we have done there is, so let us consider this. So here in the DSBS, we have taken the spectrum of the DSBS looks like this. So this is called as the center frequency of the signal. So here how to represent this is FC plus omega, and here also FC plus omega. So this is the spectrum of double sideband suppressed carrier. So as I said that whatever the dotted line present here, this is called as the suppressed carrier. So here you can see the spectrum where the center frequency is present. So this is called as what? Upper sideband frequency, and this is called as lower sideband. So here also this is the upper sideband and this is the lower sideband in the double sideband suppressed carrier. So in order to transmit the message signal, we are going to use both the spectrum in the double sideband spectrum suppressed carrier. So considering this as the message signal, so whatever the spectrum we have, we are going to represent both at the right hand side and as well as the left hand side. So that is the spectrum obtained with respect to DSBSC. Now here in the single sideband modulation, as it indicates, that is the single sideband. Instead of sending the message signal by using both the sidebands present as present in the DSBSC, what we are going to do here is we are going to consider only the single sideband, that is either USB or either LSB. So in order to represent the USB with respect to the single sideband modulation, we are going to consider the spectrum like this. So if we are going to consider this, we are going to consider this is the central frequency and FC plus omega. This is what? Upper sideband, and this is the here it is called as, so here we are going to represent single sideband frequency. So with respect to what, here we are going to send by using only the upper sideband. So this is not, we are not going to use this in order to transmit the message, but by using only the half part of the spectrum, that is upper sideband, we are going to transmit the message signal in the single sideband. That is why it is called as a single sideband. If we are going to consider with respect to the LSB, how the spectrum looks like is, so same way as we have written, that is opposite to the upper sideband. So here, if you are going to represent the frequency, this is the center frequency, and here this is the fc minus omega, and here it has got the minus fc plus omega, and here we have got this is the central frequency. So this is how we are going to represent with respect to the upper sideband and with respect to the lower sideband. So that here either any one of the sideband is used to transmit the message signal, whereas we are going to protect what? We are going to overcome the disadvantage of the power transmission as well as the bandwidth. So in order to transmit the message signal, we require the twice the bandwidth of the message signal, correct? So in order to overcome this problem, we have chosen the single sideband modulation, whereas we can transmit the message by using either USB or the LSB. So till now we have seen the frequency domain expression for the SSP. So, and we all know that why we moved on to the single sideband frequency, because in amplitude modulation and also in the double sideband suppressed carrier, we have faced the problem with respect to the power transmission as well as the bandwidth. So in order to overcome that, we have chosen the single sideband frequency, whereas in the single sideband we are going to transmit the message signal without having the carrier signal. And here we are going to explain that using either of the upper sideband or lower sideband, we are going to transmit the message signal. So in the last topic we have studied frequency domain expression for the SSP, and now we are going to see the derivation for time domain expression for SSP. Now see here, consider, we all know that in order to consider this we require the m of t and c of t. Let us consider m of t is equal to am into cos into 2 pi fm into t. So this is our what? Message signal. C of t is equal to ac into cos 2 pi fct. Let us consider the equation number 2. Keeping this, we have derived the equation for the double sideband suppressed carrier. What is that? So dsp of t is equal to c of t into m of t. Altogether, we can write the equation considering the carrier signal and the message signal, ac into am into cos 2 pi fct into cos 2 pi fm into t. Similarly, for the dsb of t, we are going to consider half into ac into am cos, taking the common of 2 pi here, 2 pi into fc plus fm into t, plus half into ac into am into cos 2 pi fc minus fm into t. So let us consider this is the equation number 3, whereas we are going to get the single frequency of fc plus fm and the single frequency of fc minus fm. Here we can see that's what, two sideband frequency can be obtained here, which is those, which are those fc plus fm, that is we call that as the upper sideband frequency, and fc minus fm, this is the lower sideband frequency. From the equation number 3, we are going to derive the equation for time domain expression both for the upper sideband as well as the lower sideband. Here you can see we have got the equation, we have got the frequency for the upper sideband as well as the lower sideband. So if you are going to represent that in a time domain expression for both the frequencies, how we can write here is, from the equation number 3, we are going to consider this as upper sideband S of USB into T is equal to half AC into AM into cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. So we can altogether write this as half into AC into AM cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FM into T minus half into AC into AM sin 2 pi FCT into sin 2 pi into FM of T, because we are going to pass this upper sideband to the converting this into, by using the time domain expression, we are going to consider this by using the Hilbert transform, whereas in the Hilbert transform we have seen the phase shifter, that is minus pi by 2, that is why we are going to get the equation with respect to cos and sin. Now this is in the terms of what? Cos A into cos B, that is we know that cos A into cos B minus sin A into sin B. Similarly, we have derived the equation for USB, that is upper sideband in the time domain expression. Similarly, we have to derive the equation for lower sideband. Here we have the equation for lower sideband, S LSB of T is equal to half into AC into AM cos 2 pi FC minus FM. So here you can see the difference, that is in the upper sideband we have considered the equation FC plus FM. Here in the lower sideband we have considered the frequency FC minus FM into T. So by using this cos A minus B, we have got the formula cos A into cos B plus sin A into sin B. So how to write this? S of LSB is equal to half into AC into AM cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FM of T plus half into AC into AM into sin 2 pi FCT into sin 2 pi into FM into T. So converting this equation, representing this equation in terms of what? Cos A minus B. Altogether, after obtaining the equation for upper sideband and for the lower sideband, in general we can write the single sideband of in representation with time domain expression, we can write like this: half into AC into AM cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FM into T plus or minus. So you can see the plus or minus symbol here, into half AC into AM sin 2 pi FCT into sin 2 pi FM into T. So let us consider this as the equation number 6. For the periodic signal, we are going to define this by using the Fourier series. What we have here is M of T is equal to, that is message signal is equal to, we are going to represent like this, summation N for the N signal. We are going to write like this, A of N cos 2 pi FM into T. Here we have got this M cap of T, that is nothing but after 90 degree phase shift by passing through the Hilbert transform, we are going to call that message signal as the M cap of T, that we are going to represent like this, summation N A of N into sin 2 pi FM into T. After representing this periodic signal defined by the Fourier series, how we are going to write for the SSB? So consider same, you are going to consider the same signal here. For SSB is equal to, you are going to write the same thing here, half into AC into AM cos 2 pi FCT, and for cos 2 pi FM into T, that is what? Message signal, correct? This is the carrier frequency, and for the message signal we are going to represent this, that summation N into AN cos 2 pi FM into T. So plus or minus. Similarly, for the second term also we are going to represent half into AC into AM sin, this is what? Frequency of the carrier, and we are going to consider the Hilbert message signal, and substituting here we are going to write summation N into A of N sin 2 pi FM into T. Now keeping this, we can alter the signal like is equal to half AC. How to write this equation is M of T. We are going to represent this M of T, AM into cos 2 pi FCT, that is what? M of T, that is our message signal, summation N, that is A of N cos 2 pi FM into T. So you have got how we have got this equation. This one we have considered as M of T. So we have retrieved this half into AC, this is M of T, summation N A of N cos 2 pi FM into T plus or minus. Here also AC divided by 2. So this one we are going to consider as what? Keep as it is, M cap of T sin 2 pi FCT. So here we are, M cap of T is nothing but what? Minus 90 degree phase shift. That is why after transmitting the message signal through the Hilbert transform. So this is the equation for time domain expression for single sideband frequency. So this is the important derivation where you have to study. So and you also have to know the how to transmit the Hilbert transform, keeping the message signal and converting that to the M cap of T. In single sideband frequency, we are going to send a message signal by keeping only the either upper sideband or the lower sideband. So what is the problem we are going to face in the single sideband frequency is, whenever we are going to consider only the upper sideband as well as the lower sideband, so what is the problem we are going to face in the single sideband is, either we have to consider full USB. So when we consider the single sideband frequency, it is not appropriate when message signal contains a significant component, whereas it consists of lower frequencies. So it is difficult to isolate one sideband. So if we consider upper sideband or the lower sideband, it is very difficult to isolate the one sideband, as both the sideband meet at the same frequency. As we all know that when we are going to represent the spectrum for this, we are going to consider either upper sideband or the lower sideband. If we are going to transmit only with respect to the single sideband frequency, whereas even the LSB will going to meet at the same carrier frequency. So this is the problem going to occur in the single sideband frequency. So in order to overcome that, what we are going to do here is, we are going for the another technique called as a vestigial sideband modulation. In this modulation, we are going to consider the either upper sideband or the lower sideband frequencies. Along with that, we are going to consider the vestigial component. So we'll see how to consider the vestigial part of the message signal. Now we know the spectrum for the message signal. We are going to represent like this. Okay. So we are going to write in the double sideband, that is, this will be the carrier frequency which is suppressed in the DSBS. So in order to represent this, we know that this is the center frequency. Here we have got FC plus omega, FC minus omega. So this is the upper sideband and this is the lower sideband. Here also we are going to represent the center frequency, that is FC plus FC minus omega. Here this is minus of FC plus omega. Okay. This is a signal for the double sideband suppressed carrier. So after that, in order to overcome, we have moved to the single sideband, whereas we are going to consider either upper sideband as well as the or else lower sideband in order to transmit the message signal. So in the single sideband, we are going to consider this, only the upper sideband frequency. We have seen what is the problem we are going to face in the single sideband frequency is, both the upper sideband and lower sideband meet at the same carrier frequency. So in order to overcome that, we have considered the vestigial sideband modulation. Here this is FC minus W. If at all we are going to transmit, the working principle of vestigial sideband modulation is, if at all we are going to consider the upper sideband and we are going to pass or send the message by using the upper sideband, along with this carrier, we are also considering the some part of the lower sideband, because this meets at the same carrier frequency. So this band is called as vestigial band. Some part of the message signal may appear across this carrier frequency. That is why we are going to consider some part of the LSB also. This band is called as vestigial band. So we are going to overcome the problem occurred in the single sideband frequency. So now let us see what are the expressions we can write for the vestigial sideband modulation. Here we are going to use the coherent detector where S of T is given to the product modulator along with the multiplied with the carrier signal, that is C of T. After that we are going to give that to the low pass filter, we are going to get the V naught of T. So here there is a derivation for that, how to get the V naught of T considering the S of T. So here we have V of T is equal to AC into cos 2 pi FCT into S of T. So this is the V of T is the output of the product modulator after multiplying with the carrier signal as well as the S of T. With respect to the frequency domain, we can represent this equation as V of F is equal to AC dash divided by 2. Because of S of T, here we are going to multiply with the single frequency, we are going to get this equation, that is S into F minus FC plus S into F plus FC. V of F is equal to AC divided by 2, AC divided by 2, M of F, H of F minus FC plus H of F plus FC plus AC into AC dash divided by 4, M of F minus 2 into FC into H of F minus FC plus M into F plus 2 FC into H of F plus FC. Here we can see we have got the multiple frequency component, that is high frequency component. When we are going to pass through the low pass filter, all the high frequency components will be removed. So let us see which are the high component frequency has been removed here. After removing that, we are going to get this. V naught of F is equal to AC into AC dash M of F divided by 4 H of F minus FC plus H of F plus 2 FC. In order to distortionless transmission, we have to consider this as a 2 into H of F. So let us consider this component as 2 H of F. To get M of F is equal to 0, we are going to consider the equation H of FC is equal to half. At the end V naught of T, we are going to get AC into AC dash divided by 2 into M of T. So this is the output across the coherent detector. So this is the output at the coherent detector, we are going to get AC into AC dash divided by 2 into M of T. So here we can conclude this vestigial sideband modulation, how we can save the bandwidth of the signal. When we consider the television, so this vestigial sideband modulation is going to be used as application in the television. Here it require what? Audio plus video. Bandwidth of the video is 4.2 megahertz. Considering when we compare this with the double sideband suppressed carrier, we are going to transmit the message over a considering two message signal, that is two upper sideband, one is upper sideband as well as the lower sideband. That is why we have considered this as a two message signal into 4.2 megahertz, that is the bandwidth of the video. It required broadband plus audio. So altogether in the DSB SC we require a bandwidth of 9 megahertz, but in the vestigial sideband modulation, instead of sending the two sidebands, we are going to send only the single sideband. We require only 6 megahertz of bandwidth for the vestigial sideband, whereas we are going to save the bandwidth up to 3 megahertz in the vestigial sideband modulation. So till now we have studied the different amplitude modulation which completes your module 1, and till here we have, along with the application with the TV, considering the television as the application, we have completed the vestigial sideband modulation which completes the module 1. In the module 2, we are going to see the angle modulation in the next class. Thank you.